Hello everybody and Merry Christmas to all of you at home watching right now, and welcome to the Christmas Day special here on your positive mental health program, The Chrissy B Show. This is a great time to celebrate with your loved ones, and I'm sure these holidays mean different things to all of us. And in just a bit, I'll be showing you what I like to do over Christmas. And what I want to do today is share with you what the Chrissy B Show family is all about and what our purpose is. The aim of the show has always been to reach all those people who need help with mental health issues or problems in general. And week in, week out, we have some brave guests who come on the show to help and motivate others. So we'll be looking back at some of the most inspirational stories we've had on the show this year. What's more, what makes the show extra special is the different segments we have to help you lead a happier and healthier life. So we'll check out some of those unique segments later on too. Plus, another very important part of this show are our regular experts, as they provide us with their knowledge and expertise in their field. So we'll also be replaying some of those. And later, I'll be talking about four things to be grateful for. But first, let's check out what Christmas was like for me growing up and what I like to do during the Christmas period now. So Chrissy B's Christmas. Well, let me start off with Christmases growing up. I remember always having a tree packed full of presents underneath, and we weren't allowed to open any of them until, not even Christmas morning, we were allowed to open them. We had to wait until everyone had had a shower, we were all downstairs for breakfast. Then after we cleared up everything, then we were allowed to go and open our presents all together as a family. That's me, my sister, and my parents. Now, my mum had this tradition even when we were, I think we were even in our 20s, where she would actually still come into the bedroom in the middle of the night and leave some smaller presents at the end of our bed. So even though we knew all about Santa and everything like that, she still insisted on coming into the room late at night to leave gifts at the end of the bed. So we were allowed to open those, of course, on Christmas morning. Then after opening all the presents and cleaning up again, because we always had to clean up after ourselves, we were off to my uncle's house for Christmas dinner with the entire family. And we just spend time there stuffing our faces and dancing, trying to dance off all the food that we'd eaten, and then basically just lazing around and then speaking with cousins. Now, more recently, since I got together with Michael, I did spend a few Christmases with him, and they were allowed to open presents at midnight, which was different. Grandma would make this thing called pepper pots. So for those of you from Guyana or from the West Indies, you're familiar with that. So we'd have that for breakfast, which is a kind of sweet oxtail, and you'd have that with bread and butter, delicious. So after that heavy breakfast, they would also have a heavy lunch and just be zoned out for the rest of the day because we were so full. And more recently, since I got married now, my Christmases have been quite a lot different. So I will normally spend Christmas Day with Michael and sometimes family and friends as well. But there are other things that I like to do over the Christmas period. One thing that I love to do over the Christmas period is to go to Winter Wonderland, because I am a huge kid at heart. So I love the family atmosphere, actually, because nowadays you don't see many families together going out together, and everyone's on their phones all the time. So going there, people don't do that. There's also a lot of tourists, a lot of families, and you see the kids being kids, basically, and, you know, doing things like ice skating and going on the rides, and it's just such a lovely atmosphere. And of course I love the food stalls, so me and hubby will go there and get our traditional burgers because they're really nice, they're really, really good, with the big chunky chips. And just walking around, and there's some nice little shops there, you can buy nice gifts for people, so that's always a must. Something else that I love to do is to visit tea shops. Well, actually, tea shops are something that I do frequently with Michael and with friends and family. So I do love to go to different tea shops where it's nice and cozy, have a hot drink and a nice dessert, and that's really fun. I would say the most important thing in my life is my faith in God. Though I had and have my family and Michael, that didn't solve the issues that I had inside. And as you guys know, you know, the issues that I had with depression and panic attacks and all the other things. So when I discovered faith and I started to receive the positive messages, and really, it was really uplifting for me. So that to me is the most important thing in my life, because that's what changed my life around. And obviously, of course, over Christmas and throughout the year, actually, I do attend church services and I go there to feed my spirit, because I think many people nowadays, they look after their body with the physical fitness, they look after their soul, which is their relationships and stuff, but a lot of people forget that they have a spiritual side as well, that when they tap into that and when they tap into faith, that also complements and can transform the other areas of your life as well. So I think that's missing from a lot of people's lives. So I make sure that I invest in my spirit as well as my body and my health and my relationships as well. And of course, because of the strength that I've received, it gives me that kind of burning desire, I would say, to help other people as well. So I'm involved in mentoring. So I do mentor other women. I help them kind of work through their issues, their problems. I help them develop personally as well, help them with any kind of problems they're going through in their family, anything like that. So I'm always there to give advice and to help other women, because I know what it's like to have been through their kind of problems. And something else I like to do over Christmas as well, because I believe Christmas should be about giving to others too. So I regularly take part in fundraising activities. So there are times when, for example, I'm out with a bucket and a fundraising collection bucket, and I'll be there the whole day in the freezing cold singing Christmas carols and trying to collect money for charity. So that is something else that I love to do as well. So there you have it, Chrissy B's Christmas, consisting of spending time with my beloved husband, friends and family, having fun, going out, investing in my spirit, and also trying to give back to my community as well. Now, you may think that because we're a show that concentrates on mental health, that we're a very serious bunch, but that's far from the truth. What's great about this show is that even though we often discuss some very tough and difficult subjects, we do know how to have a good laugh and have lots of fun. Let's take a look at this video. Take their mind off. There's a spelling mistake. I've got a couple of clips in the room, a couple of clips just to take their mind off it. Now, you... Mum, everyone's kind of waiting for me to start in the studio. But, okay, love you, sorry. Call me tomorrow.
Is the other makeup artist coming on? She's good.
Oh, I thought you were going to count us in, sorry.
Face with you.
Oh, no, I don't want to know. Not a good question. Let me start again. All right, guys, so after the break, we'll be revisiting... No, we're not going to revisit because we haven't done it yet. And before we meet our next guest, let's
goes back to what the...
What?
What happened, Chris?
I'm sorry.
This is so unprofessional. I'm never coming on this show again, ever. Sorry, no, it was me, sorry.
Doing something different for a change. And how's that good for you?
Was it?
Care of it there and then. Don't wait for testing or trial to get bigger or...
I don't remember this bit.
You know, honestly, we believe she deserves... Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. Relax.
Yeah, no.
I thought you were saying thank you.
You were saying
thank
you.
No,
okay,
problem.
Yeah. No, no worries.
We'll see you in just a moment.
Not that. Sorry.
That you have the health problem, so you have the high blood pressure, you have heart disease.
There's a squeak. Is it natural?
Oh, it's a mouse.
Stop it.
I don't know. Dr. Rob Hicks to give us the advice on this, and now no.
Oh, listen to me, let's go. Right, we're not going there. Come on, let's go. Let's go straight to it.
I'm gonna ask you.
All right, come on, let's do this. Alcohol use has risen. What a mouthful. I'm so sorry. That was really quick. Oh, I thought you were gonna count us in, sorry. So don't go away, it's not on. Down. Oh, sorry. I thought you meant me, you're not my husband. So well. Oh, stop it.
Can guys hold hands?
Oh, easy. My God, it's so cheesy.
Come on.
Who's doing the ending to this one? Mm. You are.
Great.
It's important to get the endings right on the show.
Telling us more about what stress is and how we can cope and overcome it. Oh, no, not yet. I'm sorry, you're speaking. Well, I hope you enjoyed that one. And up next, we'll be looking back at some of the most inspirational stories we've had on the show this year. And later on, I'll be talking about four things to be grateful for. So I'll see you in just a second. Hi, I'm Chrissy B, and my show is all about improving your mental health and being happy. Join me every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 p.m. on my channel, Sky 203. Visit chrissybshow.tv for more information and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Chrissy B Show. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Chrissy B Show and on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Welcome back, everyone, and if you've just joined us, Merry Christmas to you. So before the break, I talked about what I do over Christmas now that I'm all grown up. Plus, we looked at some funny moments on the show this year because we do have a lot of fun around here, even though we all work really hard. And if you've missed any of this show so far, you can head over to our YouTube channel in a few days' time and the show will be up there for you to see. And to subscribe, it's Chrissy B Show. But let's go back to the core and the foundation of this show, which is to help those in need. And we're going to be bringing back the focus to those real life stories and brave individuals who came on the show to share their story in the hope that they will be able to inspire or help others out there. So the first one is the story of a young man who bravely came on the show to talk about an addiction that he had to pornography that ruined his life. Let's take a look.
Well, from the age of 7, that was the first time I actually encountered it, from the age of 7, because I was staying over my aunts, and my cousin was basically older than us, and he said, look, I'm going to show you guys something, and I'm sure you're going to like it.
Oh, dear.
And, at the age of 7, I think the first thing that came to my mind was probably Power Rangers, like a new edition of Power Rangers or something like that. Mm. And it was porn. When I was in secondary school, so about 12 years old, that's when I had a bit more access on the internet. Which
are we talking about like every day here or...?
Now is when it started to become a bit more frequent. So not every day yet, but at least maybe 3 times every 3 days.
Okay.
You know, and I had more access because I could download them off illegal websites, which I found out when I was in school from friends. Mm-hmm. And also my friends would sell DVDs at school. So I didn't have friends. No, seriously. Uh-huh. I didn't have friends selling drugs in school. I had friends selling porn DVDs and, you know, sell it for £1 because they would probably download it and then just burn it on the DVD, and they would sell it around in school. And though I never bought it off any of my friends, I would actually either steal it from a friend or borrow it from a friend, and I would want to exchange it because I wanted something better.
I hope there's teachers and parents listening to this, because it's really important that you do check up on what your kids are getting at school. So when did it get really bad, Malcolm?
It was when I was 14, because then it was so much. It was really, it was all over the place, and the peer pressure as well, because I was still a virgin at the time, and my friends were like, you know, you should have sex. And imagine already having this kind of, you know, addictive behavior with porn, and then being introduced to sex as well. That just really drove me mentally insane, because it was like, I would see a woman and I could undress her with my eyes. I would know from the bra size to her shape literally just by looking at her past the street, and that was because of how many times I would watch porn in one day.
So you couldn't like look at a woman in a just an, I would say, a normal way. It was like, it was all kind of corrupted before.
Yeah, and it was really scary because you don't want to, but it happens. That's how it felt. I didn't want to, but it happens. I could be doing something and I could just imagine what I watched maybe the night before. And at that time now, I started watching it. Instead of 3 times every 3 days, it was probably 3 times every day, in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. You know, I became the teenager who wasn't really interested in anything else but sex and porn.
The good thing is, Malcolm, you did look for help in the end, which was great.
Yeah.
You know, you didn't keep it to yourself. It did get too much at one point, and you did open up. You joined a youth group. You
got the
help, the mentoring and stuff there, and you were able to beat this addiction completely.
Yes, I...
Now happily married.
Yeah.
Obviously, your view must have changed about women.
Oh, definitely. Mm-hmm. Definitely. It was hard, I must say. But eventually, it kind of got too much because I wanted self-control. And I wanted to be able to be normal because I knew I wasn't normal, you know. So I started to identify, again, the trigger factors, but in more detail. In fact, I was inspired by a movie that I watched. I saw a guy in the movie. He was addicted to porn, and what he did was he broke his computer. Mm. So that was the first thing I did. So
at this point, had you already spoken to someone about it?
Yes, at this time. At this point, yeah.
And what you're saying now is very important because it's like, when you'd once you'd opened up and it was out in the open and you were talking to someone about it, then it was easier to kind of break the habit, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Now, something that we love to do on this show is to treat one of our lovely viewers who's going through a hard time to a well-deserved makeover. Here's Donna Walker-Dean, who was nominated by her son Thomas to have a makeover on the show because he believed his mum deserved some pampering. Let's find out why that was. Thanks so much for nominating your mum. So tell us a bit about her. Why was it that you felt that she deserved a makeover today?
Basically, just because like she's an amazing woman. Mm-hmm. She's always been there for me all my life. Like me and my sisters went through like a hard time in our family and stuff. She's always been there.
Yeah.
She's just like an amazing person, really.
Let's introduce her. Her name's Donna. Hello, Donna, my love. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
I have to say, you look amazing.
Thank you.
You know, been in the good hands here of Megan and also Cynthia, which you're going to speak to in just a moment. But just what do you think of the makeup? Do you like it, the hair?
I love it. I absolutely love it, yeah.
Feel comfortable in it?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. And the styling as well. You like that?
Yep, definitely.
Great. Okay, so we're going to talk first of all about the makeup, Megan. Hello.
Hello.
How are you, my lovely?
I'm good, Chrissy. How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
You look gorgeous.
Oh, thank you. Down to you. All right, so tell us what you've done here on our lovely Donna.
Well, for Donna, we've got some lovely baby blue eyes here, and so we just revved it up with some pumpkin warmth. You know, her auburn hair is just amazing. Mm-hmm. So we work those colors into the cheek, into her eyes, and into her lips.
Yeah. So her eyes really standing out.
They just really pop. So she really didn't have much in terms of, we didn't do anything fancy with her eyes. We actually kept it quite simple with some mattes and some warmth. And we just went in there and just gave it that oomph with those fall colors that are just amazing, I think. She has the most amazing hair and eyes. Mm-hmm. It's just, you know, we didn't really do too much in the way of, like I said, anything fancy.
Yeah. I really love the way this drapes on Donna's figure, and it looks very regal and it's just very elegant. Now, there's a couple different looks we can do with this Duffy cape. She can wear it straight, plain like this with the gray ends pointing down, or she can do sort of like a one shoulder sort of wrap. So I'll just pull back and you can see what that looks like. Exactly. That would look really nice with skinny jeans. And also you could do something like this where you pull up the other, you know, the other color there, and it's kind of just like a double wrap. And if you just get like a full size, get a full size shot of her there. And then you could see what that looks like on the whole body. Mm-hmm. For the shoes, I just chose to put the same colors that were in the cape because she had all black underlay. And we went with another hot trend this autumn winter season, which is the leopard print. And she's quite comfortable in the shoes. And she said that she actually liked them, even though it's something she typically normally wouldn't wear.
So Donna, tell us about your life then, because you went through something very, very difficult. You were married, and then what happened? Oh, you were with someone, sorry, and what happened to that person?
Well, Thomas was 4 months old, and our daughter was 14 months old, and their dad went out to a friend's party, was helping him do a DJ there, and he was set upon in an unprovoked attack by 9 to 15 men.
Wow.
Yeah.
And then what happened?
Well, basically, they assaulted him. He came home after, was okay. I say okay, he wasn't okay, but he came home after, and then he was worried that they was going to come back to my home, and because the two children were there, he said he's going to go and stay at his friend's house overnight, so that's what he did. Later on the next day, came home, wasn't right from then onwards, very sleepy. So then I took the two children, Danny and Thomas, to hospital, to mother and baby unit, kissed him goodbye in the morning, and that was the last time, really, that he was, I don't like to say, like, Dave, because he is still him, but he was rushed to Old Church, Basden Hospital, sorry, because he had two blood clots on the brain, which leaked.
Wow. Donna, how do you cope? Because obviously it must have been very difficult when he did come home, those first, you know, few months. What was that like for you?
It was, like, you just have to try and cope. I mean, it was so hard. Obviously, I had the two children as well, and they were used to having my whole attention. So obviously, when their dad came home, after like years of rehabilitation units and that, like different ones he'd went to, I just found like I didn't have enough time with the children. And he was so demanding, he couldn't sit down. He couldn't do anything. But obviously, you know, when you care for someone and you love someone like that, you do your utmost.
Of course, yeah.
To like do whatever they need, which I did. And then
did you find that you'd found this strength that you thought you didn't have?
Yeah, definitely, cuz like I don't know how, but if I've, like a lot of my friends go, "Donna, how did you cope?" And I'm like, "I don't know." You know, it's like you're faced with something like that and you just, it's like you've got to do it. The children, you know, the children and all that. So you just focus on everything. That's got to be done, that's got to be done. You do find an inner strength.
And if you believe your loved one, a friend or even you deserve some pampering, do let us know. You can visit our website, chrissybshow.tv, and send a message through that. You can also tweet us at Chrissy B Show or leave a comment on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Well, don't go away, because after this break, we'll be looking back at the different segments we've put on the show to help you lead a happier and healthier life. Plus, another very important part of this programme are our regular experts, as they provide us with their knowledge and expertise in their fields. So we'll be checking out some of their highlights. And later, I'll be talking about the four things to be grateful for. We'll be right back, only here on The Chrissy B Show. Hi, I'm Chrissy B, and my show is all about improving your mental health and being happy. Join me every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 p.m. on my channel, Sky 203. Visit chrissybshow.tv for more information and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Chrissy B Show. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Chrissy B Show and on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Merry Christmas to all of our Chrissy B Show viewers, and I hope you're having a great time with your family and friends. And thanks for joining us here as we talk about our Chrissy B Show family. Now, before the break, we'll look back at some of the most inspirational stories we've had on this show this year. And remember, it's never too late to share your story to help others out there. So all you have to do is visit our website and contact us through there, chrissybshow.tv. You can also tweet us at Chrissy B Show and also leave a comment on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. As I've mentioned to you before, our aim here on the Chrissy B Show is to reach all those who need help. And without this bunch of particular people, we could not achieve our main goal. And there are lovely regulars who also happen to be experts in their own fields. Let's see them in action.
So put your hands on the back of your head like so. Try not to pull on your head. So pin your elbows back. And with your left foot, step forward, straddle it forward, drop your knee down.
Jonathan, oh gosh.
And back up.
Mind those shoes, Rob.
Okay, change legs. So forward, knee down, and back up. So that's a lunge with a, it's called a prisoner lunge.
Okay.
So you're pinning your elbows back as if you're a prisoner.
Okay.
Now, being unemployed does a lot of things to you. It messes with your confidence, your self-esteem, your worth, your value, who you are. And if you keep going from interview to interview, and you go to this interview and they turn around and they say, no, sorry. Go to another interview. No, sorry. After a while, you start thinking, well, what is your worth?
Yeah.
What is your value? And you start feeling devalued and get pretty depressed about it. So we got to get to that point of turning that around for someone to realize who they are, what they're worth, and what they're about, right? Now, taking that straight away, one of the tips I'll say, and I always mention this, first few seconds that you walk through a door in an interview, they've actually made their mind up about you, right? They might not say that, might say, oh, no, we don't, but it's in the subconscious, in the back of the mind. We look at people, we all do it.
The other thing about bullying as well is that bullying is what the person who's being bullied perceives it to be. It can't be defined objectively. If someone thinks they're being bullied, that complaint has to be taken seriously, and that's true of the workplace as well. Because a lot of the time, when someone says, I'm being bullied, you do get a few people, and this is why I think, Karen, you've said, no one did anything about it. You may have teachers, you may have managers who sit there and say, oh, it's not bullying, I could cope with that. No,
yeah,
the definition actually is, if you perceive it to be bullying, the complaint has got to be taken seriously.
If you've got any worries or concerns at all, go and speak to a health professional or a teacher or the SENCO, the Special Educational Needs Coordinator in your school.
Yeah.
But sort of check out for patterns and things. So, you know, are there particular triggers that seem to set your child off? Or is there a particular pattern of a day of the week that the child doesn't want to go into school? Maybe that falls into a particular lesson that they're having. Are they showing more anxiety than perhaps they were? Is their behaviour regressing in some way? And I think that way you can start to pick up on certain patterns of behaviour. And keeping a diary is always sort of quite useful, really.
Well, I think the first thing you need to do is to find out what is the root of the fear, right? If every single fear has a root, because you're not afraid of something, you know, out of nowhere. That fear has to come from somewhere. It's either something you've experienced or something you heard, like Elena
said.
Or an idea or something someone said to you or something you've seen. So the first thing is to identify that fear. And the second thing is to make people understand that the fact that you have seen something negative happen in a relationship of someone that you know, admired or someone that was close to you, it doesn't mean that's going to affect you or that's going to happen to you. Yes. The fact that you had a previous bad experience, it doesn't mean that's going to happen again. Actually, you can learn from your mistakes and make sure that doesn't happen again. So I think finding the root and let people understand that this doesn't have to happen again is a very important point.
And also, just to add to what he said, I always have something to add, don't I?
Always, that's why you're here, otherwise I would come by myself.
No, I like to always comment on his comments, you know what I mean?
Blusher, you could actually go wrong, and I guess confidence, some people, you know, like to have that flush and that, you know, that bright look or that contoured look. But sometimes it goes wrong because the positioning of the product is wrong.
Right,
so, you know, you can be confident knowing that where you actually blush is in the apples of the cheeks. So with especially a pigmented blush, you can start there and you can work your way up. And it is about kind of just pressing it lightly. You know, take a look at yourself. You ran up a flight of stairs. You're getting a bit hot. Where is that flush coming? And you can see actually where it naturally comes from. And that's what you want to achieve with makeup, is that natural beauty look.
I want to just dress this up a little bit. You know, we are in the middle of summer here, but how about a lightweight sort of
you know, tuxedo jacket. This one is done by American Vintage, and I'm just so in love with this because look at how it transforms the outfit. It's so structured, but yet very simple. And you know, she's ready to go out,
thing.
And it does come in other colors if you're, you know, willing to try other colors as well. I mean, you can keep layering this look. We can, you know, put a necklace on her. I would choose a long dangling one just for balance and just a little bit of color there as well. So we can keep adding layers if we're comfortable with it, Chrissy. Also, I thought, when I saw her picture, I thought, you know what, she's gonna look fabulous in a hat. So, So I put her in this, and again, just like brings another dimension.
It's so nice on her,
to the outfit.
Love it. Do you like that?
Yeah, really. I don't often wear hats, so it's really cool.
It really suits you.
Great.
And that's made such a difference, isn't it? Wow.
It
simple,
is, isn't
simple,
it?
But really effective. Wow.
And for the grand finale,
we
are summertime, right? So we have to have the shades as well. So we're going to show it to you with the hat on and with it off. But these ones are done by Liz Specs, and they're just very, very chic and, you know.
Now, in regards to fitness, I'm sure everyone's overindulged over these holidays and probably will continue to do so until it's over, which is perfectly understandable. But soon we'll be doing a show about tackling your fitness after Christmas, so make sure you stay tuned for that. And when we talk about fitness on the show, we always pair this up with some great homemade recipes from the MTS kitchen, which you can try at home also over the holidays. So here are some of our favourites.
Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a really quick, simple and nutritious snack for yourself, for your children, or just for the cupboard, so when you need something sweet it's always going to be there. We're going to take some dates, some nice juicy medjool dates, which are natural sugar. We know we've all gone crazy about sugar recently, but we need sugar in our diet. Sugar is in all carbohydrates. What we don't want in our diet is the processed sugar. Then take some almonds and just open up the dates and just squeeze them in. You could use any type of dates for this. These are just the ones I've got, and they're quite sticky. So you're going to end up with sticky hands. And it's a great recipe for the children, this as well. It gets them really involved in cooking. So once you've done your dates and almonds, set up a pan with some boiling water and put 200 grams of dark chocolate, break it up into little pieces and just set it on top. So that's going to take a while. Take a wooden spoon and intermittently just give it a little stir. All you need to do is get a cocktail stick or a chopstick, as I've got here, and just dunk them like that into the chocolate. And to set, these are just going to go into the fridge. So they just need a very one coat. So today I'm going to start off with some delicious sweet potatoes. They're going to be spicy, reducing all that inflammation in your body, keeping you fit, strong and healthy. So, just take your sweet potatoes and first of all, you're just going to peel them. Now we're going to only parboil these because then we're going to roast them in the oven as well. So they probably, make sure you put them into a pan that's really boiling and then boil them just until they're done on the outside for about 10 minutes. So while these sweet potatoes are cooking, we're going to start chopping the vegetables for the beef stir fry. Green beans, onions, and I'm going to add some ginger to this stir fry. I'm going to give it a quick peel. So there's your ginger. I'm going to take a chilli and just watch when you're cutting your chillies that you don't get those seeds. Remember our red and our white onion. You can choose whichever one you like or both. Our ginger, our fresh chilli and our fresh garlic. So I've just bought 2-minute steaks. So these steaks are about 150 grams each. So we're then going to just take maybe 3 spring onions, top and tail them. Our green beans, they're gonna go straight into the stir fry now. This guy wants to go in last because he's so thin. The moment he hits heat, he'll be cooked. So you wanna make sure you put them in a specific order. So I'm gonna put the asparagus in. Your Movember meal for your beautiful man, beef stir fry and chili potato wedges.
And today we're gonna be making some very quick, easy, simple recipes that are great for kids and for grown-ups. Pop in the chickpeas into a blender. The almond butter, so this is a tin of chickpeas, about 240 grams. You've got 3 tablespoons of almond butter. Just use a spoon. Just gonna go in. The reason I'm using almonds, it's very high in protein. Then we're gonna add, this is maple syrup, so it's organic maple syrup that I'm using here, just to give a little bit of sweetness. 1 little pinch of baking soda. Perfect. That's looking perfect. These would be great for taking to work. Now we're gonna add 100 grams of dark chocolate chips, and I've roughly chopped them up. I've preheated the oven to about 175, and in here I've just got some greaseproof paper, and I'm just gonna use a little bit of water on my hands to just get these into little bite-sized pieces. Okay, so our chickpea and almond cookies have had about 15 to 20 minutes in the oven, depending on the oven. What you're looking for is that nice golden color that we've got there, and they look exactly like your cookies you get in the shops. And then you can take them with you for your 4 o'clock snack, and there we have it. Chickpeas with almond butter and chocolate chip cookies.
So there you go, healthy and nutritious. Now when we return for our final part of this Christmas Day special, I'll be talking about 4 things that we should all be grateful for. We'll be right back. Hi, I'm Chrissy B and my show is all about improving your mental health and being happy. Join me every Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 10 p.m. on my channel Sky 203. Visit chrissybshow.tv for more information and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Chrissy B Show. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Chrissy B Show and on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Welcome back everyone, it's Christmas Day and I just want to say a big thank you to all of you who've decided to watch us today on this special day of the year. Now it's been great that we've had another opportunity to look back at some of the awesome moments on the show from 2015. And it's such a privilege to be part of this team and the Chrissy B Show family, and I consider you a part of this family too. And just to change up the scenery, I decided to do my tips somewhere a little different. Here it is. So now I'm going to speak about 4 things to appreciate that sometimes people complain about. So the first one is your family. So I know obviously many families have differences, and that's to be expected since each person in a family is an individual. But I think it's really a time, especially during this period, it's Christmas time, to actually really appreciate your family members for their individuality. Maybe you don't agree with everything that your family member does or believes in, but you should still respect each family member as an individual and look at the positives about each person. Everyone has their good things, everyone has their faults. So many problems that arise in families is because people tend to always look at the negatives, the things that annoy them, the things that they don't agree with, the things that
maybe the person's done in the past that they're not happy with. So I think it's really a good time from here and obviously moving forward into the new year as well, to see your family in a different light, respect each person, love each person for who they are, look at the good things about that person. And also if there's been any, I would say, disputes within the family, it's the perfect time to get together and talk things through and work things out as well. We've seen like terrible things happening this year. Life is so short already, so why not just make amends with everyone that you love and everyone that you haven't maybe spoken to in a while, and make this a really Merry Christmas. The second point I would like to bring up, something to appreciate that sometimes people complain about, is where you live, your house, and the things that you have, your belongings. So again, you might not be living in the perfect house or the accommodation maybe that you really wanted to have one day. But it doesn't mean that you shouldn't make the most of the space that you have already. So for example, even if you live in a bedsit right now and it's not great condition, but there's small things that you can do to make it your own, to make it warm and cozy for you to be in. So it might not be the ideal place, but make the most of what you have, because remember, there are lots of people, even right now as I'm speaking, that don't have a roof over their heads. They're sleeping out on the streets, people in other countries, they don't have anything, and they would love to have what you have right now. So definitely appreciate what you have. It's not to say that you will accept, you know, that as that's what you're gonna have for the rest of your life. Obviously, you know, we have a new year approaching, new beginnings, you can fight for something better. But for now, at least you have somewhere to live, somewhere to stay. You have things around you that you can use. So definitely appreciate those as well. The third thing I would say that we should appreciate is your job, your career. Now, you might be, obviously, it's Christmas Day today. You've probably stuffed yourself. You're kind of thinking about going back to work maybe day after tomorrow, say, and you're dreading it. And you're thinking, oh God, I've got to go back to my job. I can't be bothered. I don't want to go back. And all these kind of emotions that people go through during the Christmas period and in the run-up to going back to work. But again, at least you have a job. How many people don't have work at the moment, and maybe they've, even though they're jobless, maybe they've been made redundant and they've accumulated loads of debts over Christmas, maybe they've been using credit cards and stuff, and you know, the situation is even worse, but you have something to go back to. You have a job, you have an office, you have somewhere that you can go and get your monthly salary. And also, the second thing is regarding the job situation, is that you should appreciate that someone actually trusted you enough to give you that position, because employers won't just give a job to anyone. They have to trust the person to a certain extent and believe in that person's development. So that's even something else that you can appreciate, that someone has entrusted something into your hands and trusting that you will develop that. So definitely also appreciate your job if you have one. And the fourth thing to appreciate, I would say, over this period is your body. Now, maybe, as I said in the earlier point, you have stuffed your face today. Maybe you're lying on your sofa right now with a huge belly, huge full belly, feeling really ill. And you know, maybe you complain about your body. It's not maybe you say, okay, I'm overweight, or I'm underweight, or I don't have the body shape that I've always wanted, and I'm flabby here. And I think, you know, lots of complaints that especially the ladies do that, although men do it too. So I would say, again, appreciate what you have. Your body is an amazing machine. Look at all the things that it does for you. And I think people don't appreciate what they've been given enough. So even though it's not maybe perfection as you would in your eyes, but you have a body, you have to take care of it, look after it, get back on track with your fitness and with your nutrition as we get into the new year as well, as soon as possible, maybe even from tomorrow. Look after it, take care of it, because again, there are people that, you know, they've been in accidents, they're not as mobile as they used to be, and they would love, again, to have what you have. So definitely appreciate your body as well. All right, everybody, so those are my four points of things that you can appreciate. So if, while I was speaking, there were some things that you identified that you are missing in your life, don't worry, we are approaching a new year, and actually on New Year's Day, we are dedicating the whole show on how to actually change your life, how to stick to resolutions that maybe people normally wouldn't stick to certain resolutions, but we're going to be giving you lots of handy advice on how to stick to those things. It's never too late to start again. So even if you're, you know, maybe this day is something that people normally look forward to, but maybe you're feeling miserable because of all the things that are going wrong in your life, don't worry at all. The Chrissy B Show is here to help you. We're going to be with you on New Year's Day throughout the whole year to help you to reach your goals, reach your dreams, and live a happier and healthier life. Well, everyone, we are sadly reaching the end of today's Christmas Day special. But before we go, let's take a look at this visit to Winter Wonderland. It's not open today, obviously, because it is Christmas Day, but you can still visit until the 3rd of January from 10 a.m. until 10 p.m. if you want to do so. So let's take a look.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, snow's glistening. A beautiful sight, oh, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
One of the lovely things as soon as you walk into this place are all the smells. So you get like barbecue-y smells and like all of some sweet smells, and there's desserts and there's pancakes and there's waffles and there's hot dogs and there's all sorts of things, roasts as well. And then you've got all your little, as well as all the food and nice stuff here, you've got all your little stores and you can get some really, really nice things here. So it's really good. It's not a chicken dance, Excel.
It's a turkey dance for Christmas.
Oh, right.
But you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire. To face unafraid of the
you can't smell it, sorry, but it smells absolutely gorgeous.
In the meadow we can build a snowman.
Thank you, that's lovely, thank you very much.
We'll have lots of fun with Mr. Snowman.
Until the other kiddies knock him
down.
Merry Christmas.
When it snows, ain't it thrilling, though your nose.
So that's really nice.
By the ice rink, and we've watched a number of people bravely take to the ice,
it's
and it
freezing,
is by the way.
Make sure
freezing.
You're dressed up warm, lots of layers.
Absolutely.
Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy and cozy, are we?
I hear the temperatures in the magical ice kingdom are in the minus.
Well, everybody, we have reached the end of today's programme, but if you want to get in touch with us at any point, you can visit the website chrissybshow.tv. You can also tweet us at chrissybshow and also visit us on the Facebook page and leave a comment there, The Chrissy B Show. From all of us here, Merry Christmas! We don't know how. Oh, sorry. We do know how to have energy.
Okay, energy. 3, 2, 1.
And we'll continue to do so until it's over, which is perfectly understandable. Oh my goodness, there's a record. We're going to finish at 8:15.
Yeah.